Please get ready for part 7 of address by the president. 5 seconds. Start. Illegal infiltrators pose a major threat to our internal security. This is leading to social imbalance in many parts of the country, as well as putting a huge pressure on limited livelihood opportunities. My government has decided to implement the process of National Register of Citizens on priority basis in areas affected by infiltration. Security along the border will be further strengthened to prevent infiltration. While on the one hand, government is working to identify the infiltrators, on the other, it is also fully committed to protecting the victims of persecution due to their faith. In this regard, efforts will be made to amend the Citizenship Act while protecting the linguistic, cultural and social identities. My government is making efforts with complete dedication to provide a safe and peaceful environment to the residents of Jammu and Kashmir. The recently concluded peaceful elections to local bodies and to Lok Sabha have bolstered our efforts. My government is committed to take all necessary steps for the development of Jammu and Kashmir. My government is resolutely working to eradicate the menace of Naxalism from the country. Considerable success has been achieved in this direction during the last 5 years. The area affected by Naxalism is reducing continuously. In the coming years, development projects will be expedited in these areas, which will benefit our tribal brothers and sisters residing there. Honorable members, my government is rapidly taking forward the work of modernization of the army and the armed forces. India is going to receive the delivery of Rafale fighter aircraft and Apache helicopters in the near future. Special emphasis is being accorded by the government to manufacture of modern armaments under Make in India. The policy of indigenously manufacturing weapons such as modern rifles and cannons, tanks and combat aircrafts is being carried forward successfully. Defense corridors coming up in Uttar Pradesh and Tamil Nadu will further strengthen this mission. While fulfilling our security requirements, export of defense equipment is also being encouraged. Respect towards soldiers and martyrs enhances self-respect and enthusiasm among the forces and also strengthens our military capabilities. Hence, all possible efforts are being made to take care of our soldiers and their families. Through one rank, one pension, increased pensionary benefits to ex-servicemen and expansion of health facilities, efforts are being made to improve their living standards. The National War Memorial near India Gate in Delhi, built by my government 7 decades after India's independence, is a tribute to the martyrs by a grateful nation. Similarly, my government has set up the National Police Memorial in memory of police personnel who were martyred while safeguarding the security of the country. Honorable members, inspiration from history guides us towards the future path of nation building. It is our duty to preserve the memory of our nation builders and gratefully remember them. There have been many such efforts during the last 5 years. Dandi Museum has been built to honor Pujya Bapu and the historic Dandi March. Statue of Unity, the tallest statue in the world, has been built as a mark of our gratitude to the Iron Man Sardar Patel. Kranti Mandir has been set up at the Red Fort in Delhi as a tribute to Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose and other freedom fighters of Azad Hind Fauj. 26 Alipur Road in Delhi, the site of Baba Saheb Dr. Bhim Rao Ambedkar's Mahaparinirvana, has been developed as a national memorial. A museum is also being built in Delhi as a mark of respect to the contributions of all our former prime ministers of the country. My government, inspired by Sardar Patel, is committed to further strengthen the spirit of Ek Bharat, Shreshth Bharat. For this, it is essential to accord importance to national ambitions and regional aspirations. All forms of dialogue and cooperation will be encouraged to achieve this. Guided by the principle of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas or Sabka Vishwas, it is the endeavor of my government to ensure that no citizen is left behind in India's journey of development. Honorable members, India had to pass through a long period of subjugation. But throughout this period, Indians kept fighting for independence in different parts of the country. The longing for freedom and willingness to make sacrifices to achieve freedom had never waned. This desire for independence culminated into the Quit India movement in 1942, when the entire nation was determined to achieve independence and even to sacrifice their lives in this cause. Contributing to the freedom struggle was the only thought behind all the actions of our countrymen. We achieved our independence in 1947 on the strength of this collective spirit. Today, all of us are again at a juncture of creating history. We are striving to launch a new movement for ushering in a new era. Our resolve today will determine the shape of the India of 2047 when we celebrate the centenary of our independence. Today, our country is enriched with experiences of a 72-year journey since independence. The nation is moving ahead only by learning from these experiences. All of us have to move ahead with the resolve to realize the idea of New India by the year 2022, when we celebrate the 75th anniversary of India's independence. Thus, in the New India, in the 75th year of its independence, farmers' income will be doubled. Every poor will have a pakka roof over his head. Every poor will have access to clean fuel. Every poor will have electricity connection. No poor will be compelled to defecate in the open. Every poor will have access to medical facilities. Every village in the country will be connected by roads. River Ganga will flow uninterrupted and pollution free. In collaboration with states, India will be close to becoming a $5 trillion economy. We will be progressing towards joining world's 3 largest economies. An Indian will unfurl the tricolor in space entirely on the strength of indigenous resources, and we will provide leadership to global development with a new zeal and confidence. Honorable members, if the gap between the public and the government is reduced and public partnership is ensured, our countrymen can transform government schemes and programs into mass movements. This is the way forward to achieve transformative national goals. Adopting this approach, programs like the Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao and Swachh Bharat Abhiyan evolved into mass movements. On the strength of people's participation, we will also achieve the objective of a new India. Stop.